Imagine that you're in a car in Baton Rouge trying to go to the grocery store for some milk and eggs at 5 p.m. on a Friday. Might end up looking a little something like this. Now imagine if 33 million cars were off the road for a year in the U.S. It's a little better, right? Better for you getting home on time and better for the environment, since those cars aren't emitting greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide. 33 million cars represents the equivalent amount of carbon dioxide that our world's coastal wetlands take in every year. Like sponges absorb and hold water, plants absorb carbon dioxide, or CO2, from the atmosphere during photosynthesis and hold it in the form of carbon in the soils below. Specifically, salt marshes are one of the best ecosystems for this to occur, since their soil is covered in a layer of water most of the time. When plants die, they fall below the water and form peat soils, rather than decomposing and releasing carbon back to the atmosphere. This means that carbon buried here can stick around for hundreds or even thousands of years. Coastal wetlands, including salt marshes, are so good at this process, scientists even gave carbon stored there its own name, blue carbon. Now, although natural salt marshes like this one are excellent at capturing blue carbon, these ecosystems are unfortunately disappearing rapidly in South Louisiana. To combat this problem, several agencies are implementing marsh creation projects all along our coast. These new sites offer benefits like flood control and bird habitat, but what we don't yet know is how these sites accumulate and store blue carbon. That's where my research comes in. I want to find out the rate at which newly created marshes accumulate carbon and what environmental characteristics influence these rates. To do this, I studied a 32-year sequence of created dredge sediment marshes in Sabine Wildlife Refuge in southwest Louisiana. I took a bunch of soil cores like this one and measured the amount of carbon held in the peat above the dredge sediment. I found that after 32 years, this marsh accumulated almost 14 centimeters of peat, which held nearly 5 times more carbon than a marsh created only 5 years ago. So why does this matter? Well, with millions of dollars slated to go to Louisiana coastal restoration in the upcoming years, it's really important to know how these new projects will function. If we can quantify carbon accumulation rates and identify which environmental variables drive these rates, we can inform salt marsh planning and design. If we create marshes that can offset carbon emissions, we can maybe even create a dent bigger than 33 million cars. Thank you.